Kickoff press conference here at Madison Square Garden. We're very excited to be back here in New York City at the Mecca of Boxing in Madison Square Garden. I think we're all pretty much, everyone has their place now, so we can start the press conference. This is the official, even though we announced the fight a couple weeks ago, this is the official press conference with all the principals here present. So we're really excited about coming back here. We're excited about two middleweight champions fighting against each other here at the Mecca of Boxing. It'll be on HBO pay-per-view. It doesn't get any bigger than this. This is what Emanuel Stewart used to say when he said, "Welcome to big time boxing. This is big time boxing, and this is a big time event," and the fans have responded. Joel Fisher, who's our host today at the Garden, he'll explain about the ticket sales, but we couldn't have been happier with the reaction from the fans, record-breaking reaction. And we really want to give David Lemieux, Camille Estefan, Bernard Hopkins, and the whole team at Golden Boy a lot of credit. When we first announced the fight and we were doing interviews, I was doing interviews from my side, Oscar was doing interviews from the Golden Boy side, and one reporter asked me, in one word, how do you explain this fight? Or describe the fight? And I said, finally. Finally, someone, another champion, is willing to get in the ring with Gennady Golovkin. And we have to give David Lemieux and his entire team a lot of credit for that. And you see how the fans react. There's no rematch clauses. It's two of the hardest punching middleweights, two champions fighting against each other, and may the best man win. And that's the drama that the fans like to see. And that's the winner of this fight, October 17th, will be the best middleweight champion in the world. And that's what the fans appreciate. With that, the only way this fight was possible is with the support of HBO and the pay-per-view division, but also the support of Madison Square Garden. It was our goal when Gennady first came here to America to fight, to be here in Madison Square Garden. It's the biggest stage in the world. It's the media capital in the world here in New York City. And you see the quick rise. It was 3 years ago, September 1st, 2012, when he made his HBO debut. And I believe it's the fastest rise of any fighter fighting in New York, in North America, 8 times on HBO, and now making their debut on the pay-per-view. So with that being said, we have to give a lot of credit to Joel Fisher and his entire staff here at Madison Square Garden, Sal Federico, Adam Thier, Larry Torres, everyone at the Garden has been very supportive. And this event wouldn't be here and wouldn't be as successful as it is. So I'd like to introduce our host, Joel Fisher.
Thanks, Tom. You know, we do a lot of these, and I get up here and I get really excited about announcing the fight. This one's different. This one is going to be special. This is going to be a great night, and another historic night of boxing here at the Garden. So as Tom said, we're here to officially announce the Golovkin-Lemieux middleweight unification bout. It's a fight not to be missed. I'll say it now right up front, and trust me, this is not a sell. If you want to come to this fight, get your tickets now. We've sold already over 15,000 tickets in less than a week. We set a record on our pre-sale, almost doubled the highest pre-sale we had previously. This fight's going to sell out. It's going to sell out quickly. If you want, there's only a few tickets remaining as it is. We're trying to work with HBO and a couple of the other groups to release some seats, see if we can free up some more seats, because that's the type of demand that we have. It's going to be a great night. We've been host here at Madison Square Garden to the biggest and brightest moments in sports and entertainment in our 135-year history. We've had Ollie Frazier. We've had a visit from the Pope in 1979, and now we're going to have another visit from the Pope in September, on September 25th. We've had presidential conventions, NBA and NHL championships, Rolling Stones, Taylor Swift, you name it, we've hosted them all. We had 17,000, over 17,000 fans here just a few months ago for Vladimir Klitschko's successful defense of his world heavyweight title against Brian Jennings. Fans from all around the world recognize the Garden as the mecca of boxing, and it's only appropriate that this great fight is staged here, right at the place where boxing should be, Madison Square Garden. Will Gennady Golovkin's name someday stand with the greats in the middleweight division? Sugar Ray Robinson, Jake LaMotta, Carlos Monzon, Joey Giardello, Marvin Hagler, Bernard Hopkins, who's here today. All of whom has fought at Madison Square Garden, and many of whom, like Gennady, made their name at the Garden. We certainly look forward to having Gennady back. You know, Tom talked about his vision years ago. I've said this before, but I think it was February 7, 2012, Tom brought Gennady into the Garden to my office and said, we've got a great fighter here. We want to make the Garden our home. We believed Tom, we had a great relationship with Tom, we had seen a little bit of what Gennady had done, and we said, you know what, we're in. We want this to be his home. And obviously you don't know what's going to happen in boxing and how a fight is going to turn out. We had a great sense, and we like to feel that we played a little bit of a role in the success Gennady has had. Obviously, couldn't have happened without the incredible talent that he has, but we're really, really proud of that relationship that we have. We also would like to welcome David Lemieux and his entire team to the world's most famous arena. Like Tom said, somebody of great quality finally stepped up, and we really appreciate that. This is a great opportunity for David as well. He's a world champion, a knockout artist in his own right. He's KO'd 31, I believe, of his 36 opponents. So just think about that. What Gennady's done, what David's done, there's going to be fireworks at the Garden on October 17th. We love working with Tom. I want to thank him and his entire staff. We want to thank Erica and Bernie. It's always really a pleasure working with you guys. We're also thrilled to really be working with Golden Boy again, Oscar De La Hoya, Bernard Hopkins, Eric Gomez, Robert Gaspari, and Monica Sears. They're a great team, and they've really been a great help in this entire promotion. It's also great working with HBO, and now it's HBO pay-per-view. Ken Hirschman, Mark Taffet, Peter Nelson, Tammy Ross. We love working with those guys. And you know what? A lot of people are not going to be able to get in to this fight that want to come here and see it, so at least you have a great option on HBO pay-per-view. And of course, David Berlin and his entire staff at the New York State Athletic Commission. Again, you know, dreams are made here at the Garden. This is, you know, the top of the top perform here. This is going to be a great historic night of boxing at the Garden. I really suggest you don't miss it. Tickets are going fast, and we really look forward to seeing it. It's almost too long to wait for the 17th, but we have to. It's going to be a great night. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Joel. We couldn't have a better host or better staff than Madison Square Garden, so we really appreciate their help and their support. You see all the belts lined up here. Each belt signifies, it's very meaningful in the sport of boxing. It means you're the best. David Lemieux just won the IBF title. Gennady has the WBA Super Championship, the IBO Championship, and also the WBC Interim Championship. To say a few words on behalf of the WBC. Also, we have a great co-feature that we've announced. Is Chocolatito Gonzalez, who's a WBC flyweight champion. He's gonna be fighting against Brian Deloria, who's also a former champion. And that's a tremendous co-feature fight. So it's just added value for the fans that night. So to say a few words on behalf of the WBC, and we have a great string of middleweight championship fights coming up. October 10th is supposed to be Andy Lee. October 17th, David Lemieux against Gennady Golovkin. And then November 21st is just announced Cotto versus Canelo. So it couldn't be a better time now for the middleweight division all the champions fighting, and the winners mandated to fight each other. The winner of this fight between Triple G and David Lemieux is mandated to fight the winner of Cotto against Canelo. And the fans couldn't be better. I mean, they couldn't have a better opportunity right now for the middleweight division. So I'd like to introduce Jill Diamond on behalf of the WBC.
The World Boxing Council believes that every fighter that steps in the ring is a hero, but very few of them get the chance to fight for a world championship, even fewer for the green belt, let alone all these belts. So one thing I know for sure, that no matter who wins on the 17th, the fans will win, because these gentlemen will rock the ring. So the reason I'm here, though Tom took away my speech, is to read an announcement from Mauricio Sullivan, the president of the WBC. The winner will have the right to fight the winner of the great fight between Cotto and Canelo for the undisputed WBC championship. The WBC wishes to congratulate K2, HBO, Madison Square Garden, Eye of the Tiger, and Golden Boy, for setting the stage for so many great fights to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Joe. As many of you know, Gennady's rise to being one of the most recognized figures in the sport of boxing worldwide, not just in America, worldwide, is because of his fights being shown on HBO and all the marketing support that they've given us. He has an exclusive multi-fight contract with HBO. He's had 8 appearances now. And so we're really looking forward to his first HBO pay-per-view fight. The support from Ken Hirschman, from Mark Taffet, from Tammy Ross, from Peter Nelson, without their support, he wouldn't be where he's at today, and this fight wouldn't be happening. So on behalf of HBO pay-per-view, I'd like to introduce Tammy Ross.
HBO and HBO pay-per-view to announce this highly anticipated world middleweight unification between Gennady Golovkin and David Lemieux. There is no doubt that this is a great fight, sure to be the fight of the year candidate, and one worthy of Golovkin's debut headlining a monumental pay-per-view event. Both Golovkin and Lemieux have each registered more than 90% of their victories by knockout. The undefeated Golovkin has knocked out 20 consecutive opponents, while defending his title 14 times. And David Lemieux, he's won 9 in a row, 7 by knockout, capturing the middleweight title in dramatic fashion. True to be an instant classic, Madison Square Garden, the mecca of boxing, is the place for this showdown. The house where legends are made, the best face the best, and the crowds go wild. There will certainly be fireworks on October 17th. The event will be produced by HBO and distributed live on October 17th throughout the United States by HBO pay-per-view. All pay-per-view providers, cable, satellite, telcos have already signed on. Deals are done. They will be pushing this in a big way. This is the fight of the fall. We look forward to announcing a full slate of programming that will air on HBO and all our digital platforms, spotlighting the challenging weeks ahead for both Golovkin and Lemieux as they prepare for this event. We are pleased to announce the suggested retail price for this event. Featuring a loaded undercard and the top middleweights in the world, the suggested retail price will be $49.95. This $49.95 price point is an appreciation for the support Gennady Golovkin feels from his fans. There should be no reason, pricing specifically, for this spectacular event. There's no obstacle in watching Golovkin and Lemieux and the brilliance these fighters will bring to the ring on October 17th. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tammy. You see, with that price point, we want as many pay-per-view subscribers or fans to be able to see this fight. And so, just like we priced the tickets reasonably with my discussions with Golden Boy and with HBO pay-per-view, we felt that price point would really generate a lot of interest on the pay-per-view sales. At this point, I'd like to introduce representing our co-promoter, Golden Boy Promotions. They couldn't have had a better representative here than Bernard Hopkins. Bernard Hopkins holds the record for the number of middleweight championship defenses, 20 middleweight championship defenses. That in itself is an historic accomplishment. I was here when Bernard fought Felix Trinidad here in Madison Square Garden, one of the most anticipated middleweight fights at that time. So it's my pleasure, and Bernard will introduce his whole side. It's my pleasure to bring up the great Bernard Hopkins.
First, how are you back on? This is really surreal. I spoke to a couple of reporters earlier about this middleweight unification. Because rarely in boxing, unfortunately, we don't have these type of events where you can say that one guy in a division is going to represent that division. And it takes a long time for that to happen, and it's here. We have it again in Madison Square Garden. So to be able to be here, as I use the word surreal, not only as a partner of Golden Boy, but also as someone that left his DNA, literally, in history, here in this building. And as Triple G maul down the guys he fights as he steps in, and I'm a big fan of his. And also, the new I guy has been doing his part in the middleweight division. I can say proudly that the middleweight division has been left in great hands, and I'm proud of that. One thing I want everybody to understand about fighting the best, as we at Golden Boy, myself, Oscar De La Hoya, and everyone that's outside of us, the networks, HBO. And you know what, the fans, and also spoke loud, and some, if not most of the reporters, to recognize that we said that, now we want to show y'all. And this is one of the process of showing you. And that's what I'm proud of, is that we boldly went out and said that's what we want to do. But it normally, things happen in other situations where it's just all talk. So here we are, and I'm proud to deliver, and we proud to deliver at HBO and also at Golden Boy this particular fight. So as I thank K2 Promotion for not only being willing to put their guy in with our guy and vice versa, Golden Boy, and also I have the Tiger Promotion. We all wanted to get this done, and we're here. And so, when the middleweight division that I left in the great hands of these two fighters, to me, they have the baton to take it to where their legacy starts in October in that ring. And to be there to witness that, knowing that this division, the middleweight division, is the division that built my legacy. Yeah, I stopped over at light heavyweight. But the middleweight division is the division I made who I am today. And so, as I like to thank everyone that understand the history of middleweight division, from the Ray Robinsons, from the Ray Leonards, from the Marlon Hagler, to the Philly middleweights, and of course, myself. This is something that's really, really, to me, special. And so, thanks to two of the guys that willing to fight each other for that reason. Also, I like to say to people that when you have the knockout ratio of both of these fighters, you don't have time to go get your popcorn when they're announcing this fight. No, seriously. You don't have time to sit there and say, look, you know, I want to come in. No, this fight here, I don't see going the distance. Obviously, I want my guy to be the one who raises his hands down. But this is that type of fight where when you're dealing with firepower, you can see. Triple G said in his interview, I was air hustling. He said, oh, I might go 12 rounds. Hey, listen, he might be right, but wrong with who's going to not go, but he might be right. Who knows? This is that type of fight that you know it's going to be fireworks. So I want to say to everybody that Golden Boy and HBO can speak for themselves, but HBO also, because it takes a team effort to do it, made it happen. And also, I like to bring up a guy that I got to respect because he respect me from day one in Canada. And I watched the way he handles and take care of and respect his fighters. That's important to me because I'm really keyed on those who deserve respect should get respect. And I want to bring him up right now to introduce his champion, our champion, Camille Stephan.
So there you have it, another great video for ESNews. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.